Hi again from the garden. So it's the first week of June and I thought it was the perfect time to do this year's very first garden tour video. Now, if you're new to my channel, I garden in zone 5A in Northwest Iowa and I grow both cut flowers and vegetables. And so in this video, I want to give you a tour of my cut flower garden. And then in a separate video, I'm going to give you a tour of both of our vegetable gardens. So a little bit of backstory on this garden space. This is just the second season that I have planted in this garden. This space is downtown right next door to my photography studio. It's about 30 by 50 in size. And this is my first official year growing cut flowers to sell as market bouquets. I would say my style for this garden is a little more on the cottage garden size. I'm not growing my cut flowers in long market rows like a lot of people do. For one thing, I just don't have that space. But my favorite type of garden is a cottage garden. And so I am trying to grow and place everything kind of in a cottage garden style. And you'll see that throughout the video. So this year so far has definitely been a learning experience. Over the winter when I decided that I wanted to do this, I did a lot of research online, book reading, watching YouTube videos to kind of get a plan for the year. And let me say, it's already been a learning experience and I am already planning for next year. So let me show you the garden. So the first area that I want to show is the area right around the greenhouse. Now this greenhouse I just put in this spring about 2 months ago, and I actually posted a video about it, kind of a time lapse of how I assembled it. I got this online from Wayfair. It's the OutSunny brand and it's a 6x10 hobby greenhouse. I actually was able to put it together all by myself over the course of about 3 afternoons. But anyway, I have the area around the greenhouse completely planted full of flowers. So the area in front of the greenhouse, I have mostly low growing flowers. I have some nasturtium. I have calendula. In the two planters that flank the door of the greenhouse, I have some dahlias that I started from seed. Then over in this side, I have a small patch of celosia. And then on the other three sides of the greenhouse, that is where all of my snapdragons are planted. Now, I also did a video when I planted all of my snapdragons, but I have about 12 different varieties that I planted. And I have the taller ones closest to the greenhouse, and then the shorter varieties, which are still tall for cut flowers, those are planted on the outside. And my snapdragons have probably tripled in size in the last couple weeks. To be completely honest, when I planted these in the ground, I was a little bit nervous. They were looking okay, but they were a little bit yellow. I think they had just been in their seed trays too long, but they have really taken off. After I pinched them, they started branching and they are just growing like crazy. So I'm really excited to see when they'll start flowering. So next, let me show you the bed across from the greenhouse. So the next bed I have is a mix of some shrubs, perennials, and annuals that I planted from seed this year. This is on the south side of the garden, so it is on the north side of the building that is next door to me. So it is shaded right now, which is really nice in the afternoon. In front of me, I have 4 of the Proven Winners Incrediball hydrangeas. I have 2 white and 2 blush. They're relatively small right now, but I know in the coming years, they're gonna get really large. But while they're small, I'm using the space in front of them to plant annuals. And so I currently have a patch of dark opal basil, which will be a really good filler for my bouquets. And then I have all of my Lysianthus planted here. So if you have ever grown Lysianthus, you know that they are pretty tricky. This is actually my first year growing Lysianthus. So I had a couple varieties that I tried that did not do well at all. Pretty sure it was my fault. But I did have one variety that did amazing, and that is mostly what I have planted, and that is the Roseanne Black Pearl. They're really starting to grow well. They're starting to shoot upward. And so I'm pretty excited to see how these turn out. And then over in the corner of this bed, I have an old garden gate. I have some seeds started that are Morning Glory. And so those are gonna vine up the side of it. I have a heuchera planted that actually came out of my parents' garden. It had pretty much died off from the winter, and so my mom gave it to me, and it is totally flushed back to life. Then I plugged in a coleus and then a few celosia that I picked up at a local garden center. So then also in this patch right behind me, I have some poppies and some delphiniums. Both are getting ready to bloom. And then right next to me, I have a patch of cress planted. I direct sowed this about a week ago, and cress is a really good filler for market bouquets, so I'm gonna try that out this year. And then also right next to the cress, I have a little patch of Dara and some Orlea that I direct seeded. That has not come up yet, but those will also be fillers. Then the rest of this entire bed, all the way from where I'm standing to the end, is planted with zinnias. Now, I grew zinnias in this bed last year and they did amazing. Zinnias are gonna be one of the focal flowers in my market bouquets. I should mention, I have quite a few of those. This being the first year I'm doing these market bouquets, I'm growing flowers like sunflowers and zinnias and straw flowers that I have grown before that I know can be focal flowers in my bouquets. And then a lot of the other flowers I'm growing in smaller quantities to test them out and see how I like them and how well they grow for me. So zinnias I know grow amazing. And so in this spot, I have about 19 different varieties of zinnias that I have started from seed. A lot of them are starting to pop up. I just need to thin them out when they get a little bit taller, but I think they're gonna be great here. And right next to me, I have one random yarrow plant. Yarrow is something that I want to grow more of next year. I think this is the peach variety. On the outside of my fence in my cottage garden area, I have some white yarrow that is also about ready to bloom. So this is one of the beds where I'm growing a lot of the different flowers that I'm testing out that I mentioned. So this bed is a mix of straw flowers. There's some Rudbeckia across the front here. I believe it's the Sahara Rudbeckia. Then I have some lime marigolds. Now marigolds I know obviously grow really well for me, but I have a couple calendula plants. I have some more Orlea. There's some pincushion flowers. There's some status seeker white. And then I plugged in some celosia at the very back of the bed that I just picked up at a local garden center just for fun. And then you can see behind me my massive hollyhock plant. Now the bed behind me is where I'm growing all of my sunflowers, and I'll show you that in a minute. But these hollyhocks self-seeded, and I'm just kind of letting them take on a life of their own, because in cottage gardens, hollyhocks are the perfect plant, and I absolutely love how they look. So this part of the bed, I know that I can't grow a lot because that hollyhock is getting so big. So behind me, I just plugged in a few annuals, like some Dusty Miller and a couple more amaranth plants for fun, just to add some color in that area. And then along the side of my building, you'll see the trellises that I have. In front of those trellises, I have planted some black-eyed Susie vine. Those I'm hoping will completely cover those trellises and make a flower wall. Then just down from my hollyhocks, I have this raised bed that is about 6 by 20, and this is where all of my sunflowers are getting planted at. I've grown sunflowers in this exact spot for the last 2 years, and they grow really well here. This is on the south side of my building, and this is the hottest part in the garden, and sunflowers pretty much grow anywhere, and so this is where these are gonna live this year. Now you'll notice I also have some bachelor buttons planted here, these self-seeded from last year. Bachelor buttons is also something that I want to grow more of next year. They're such an early bloomer and I feel like I need more early flowers, but I'm just letting those grow on their own. I have another hollyhock in the corner, and then right in the middle of the bed I have one random blue glitter sea holly, which I'm hoping to save the seeds from this year and plant more of those next year. Now my sunflowers that are going in this bed, I am succession planting these, and I've already planted 2 rounds of those. I have a video where I planted the first round, but I'm planting about 70 sunflowers during each planting, and I plan to do about 5 different succession plantings about 10 to 14 days apart, and then this should give me a nice spread of sunflowers throughout the whole season. I'm also planting only pro-cut sunflowers. Pro-cut sunflowers are pollenless, which is perfect for market bouquets. Right now I've been planting mostly the oranges, golds, and white sunflowers, but then more towards when I want the fall planting, that's when I'm gonna plug the reds and the plums into the mix. Okay, so I have a few more beds that I have planted. Right next to my air conditioner here, which I totally wish was not here, but that is nothing that I can change. I have a little patch of gomphrena. I have orange, white, and I believe the purple variety. Those will be a really cute addition to market bouquets. And then right in front of me here, we're getting close to where the pergola is going, and so none of that is fully planted, but I do have a large patch of celosia planted here, and then I've plugged in some asters also. Now the asters are not looking really good right now. Honestly, I think they were in their cell trays too long. They are flushing a lot of new green growth from the center, so I think they'll be just fine. And I have one more bed to show. Okay, so the last spot that I have planted inside of my garden is my dahlia bed. Now, I currently only have 15 dahlia tubers planted because this is the area where we're working on the pergola. Hopefully in about a week, that'll be all finished and I can plant everything else. But these are all different varieties. I'm planting as many varieties as I can this year just to try them out. So most of the tubers that I ordered were all singles. But I would say I probably have about 20 more to plant that I'm gonna plug in around both of the posts of the pergola, and I think it's gonna look really beautiful. Okay, so that's it for this video. One of the next ones I'll have coming out will be a tour of our vegetable gardens, and then stay tuned also for the video on the complete transformation of the pergola and garden shed area. So we'll see you soon.